trying something different with the monogram. We're gonna be projecting a monogram, and we're gonna be using a projector as opposed to an actual gobo projector, if you will. We're gonna be using a traditional like movie projector, PowerPoint projector. We're gonna be using this now. What's happening? What's going on? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the vlog. And more importantly, welcome back to another product spotlight video. Today we are talking monogram. Everybody loves to see their name and likes. If you guys have been watching my recent videos, you guys saw that lately I've been using a standard regular projector to actually do my monograms. And a lot of you guys had questions. What I'm using is a standard Epson projector that you can get on Amazon. It's the Epson LCD projector model H474A, whatever that means. But essentially, it's just a $350 projector, and this is what I've been using to do my monogram projections as opposed to using a standard gobo projector. If you guys have seen my videos, you guys have seen me complain about gobo manufacturers sending the gobo after the event actually happened, receiving the wrong order, and sometimes even the wrong size. So you're kind of at the mercy of these gobo manufacturers. And a lot of you guys said just get a projector. No more relying on gobo manufacturers. All you have to do is make a design. You save that design into a little USB, plug it into the back of your projector, and turn it on, and you're good to go. The projector will do its job. A con, however, is that projectors aren't really designed to do projections like we do for weddings that you guys have seen. If you get a real fancy projector, you might be able to get more features. However, for what this is, you don't really want to invest a crazy amount of money, because essentially it's just displaying some people's names. And that brings us up to our next topic: what projector should you use? Essentially, it doesn't really matter. Obviously, you don't want a dirt cheap projector. You want something that's quality, something that's bright, and something that's made to last. The real science behind it is a mount. You need a mount that's gonna let you maneuver the projector all around. When you're doing monogram projections, you could be shooting up, you could be shooting straight forward, which is the ideal situations, but oftentimes you're not gonna have that luxury. You're really at the mercy of the venue. The mount that you use for your projector is going to make or break whether or not you can use a projector. So here I'm using a mount from Colorado Sound and Light, and it's designed to fit multiple different projectors, and it's really quite an easy setup process. You just screw it in, and then you'll also get a ball head joint similar to what you would find in a camera tripod. So this is it right here, and as you can see, I have full rotation on this mount here, so I can shoot it all the way down 90 degree angle, or I can do 360 spin wherever I want. And then once I find my spot, I just lock it into place. And on the bottom is a cup mount designed to fit over standard speaker tripods, so you can essentially just use a speaker tripod, put this on top of it, lock it in, and then screw the projector on top. This right here is a gravity stand. Now, so it's got this base plate here, and the way this works is you have a little sub-mount screw thing here. You mount this on, and boom, we have a stand. Base plate is really heavy, so you know it's sturdy. Lift it up. It goes up really high, by the way. This is about, I don't know, 6-7 feet. For the purposes of this video, I'm gonna bring it down because I am short. So next up, we'll take our mount, place it on top, push it down, lock it into place. Our projector mount is on as well. Place this on top. All right, cool. So now that our projector is attached, I can kind of show you guys what I mean. So we can do a straight 90 degree angle if we want to project it straight down, or maybe straight out if you're lucky. Sometimes you might even have to shoot it up a little bit. But the beauty is that I can maneuver the projector any way I want. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to project it behind myself so you guys can get a nice picture. I have a 25 foot IEC to power this. Plug it in, plug it in. Let my slack dangle down to the floor. The projector comes with a remote control. Let's go ahead and power this bad boy on. Power on. The lamp is heating up. Pro tip, you might want to carry around an extra lamp with you just in case in transport you shatter your lamp. Once the projector is on, it's self-explanatory to use. All you do is you plug in your USB right into the back. I'm just going to show you guys the monogram from a couple of weeks ago. This is Lisa and Terry. And as you guys can see, I can zoom in and out. I can kind of place it wherever I want, adjust my focus, and just like that we have our monogram. Now here's a little bit of a con. You can't really avoid that halo effect from the square box that the projector produces. However, it's not gonna be noticeable. Let me see if it shows off better here. With two different fabrics, you can kind of see it on the left hand side. However, once you project on something lighter, it's not gonna show. Now, if you wanna do animated monograms, you can charge extra for that because obviously you have to animate the darn logo. So I'm gonna leave a link to this small media projector that you can buy if you wanna do animated monograms. Also, if you have a really cheap projector that doesn't read JPEGs, you can buy something like this. It's a small media player. I have some Velcro on the bottom and some Velcro on the top just so that it doesn't fall off. Stick it right on top, and I'm gonna go into the HDMI input. The little media player also comes with a remote. On top here, we have our media, and I plugged in the USB into the media. Now the USB input from our projector is powering our media. We have a super short 6-inch HDMI cable coming from the media into our projector, and it's really just that simple. So here's the thing, when you have multicolor animations, you're gonna get way more haloing. As you guys can see, this is the haloing that I was talking about, that rectangle. However, like I said, it's not too noticeable. But as you guys can see, it's a really cool effect. So you can do some real cool things with a projector like this. Check that out. That is freaking awesome. So there you guys have it. Some pros, some cons, a look at what it's like to do monogram projections, gobo projections, using a standard projector. If you guys want to check out the mount, I'll link it down below. It's from Colorado Sound and Light, as well as this media player. They sell that as well. You can probably get the whole package right from Colorado Sound and Light. They sent me a discount code if you guys do want to buy it, and I'll list all that information down in the description of this video. If you have any additional questions, any comments or concerns, let me know down in those comments below. I'll be in there answering your questions. Like this video if you like this, subscribe if you're new around here, and if you really want to help me out, don't forget to turn on that bell so that you can be notified next week when I'll show you guys how to make the monograms for projections. So subscribe for that. Peace. Bye.